Let's take two examples. Let's talk about this entire journey by taking two examples of two highly profitable and highly successful consumer companies, Cera and Asian Paints. We all know the business model they are involved in. Let us see the chart of these two companies and try to see how the value unlocking and momentum is interrelated. So I'm going to do a simple trading view screen share. I can do the same in StockEdge, but let us use trading view for this simple analysis. Now, Cera was trading at a price of around 100 rupees in 2007. In fact, let's go back. You know, whenever we look at the stock from historical data perspective, you will have a very different impression about the stock. So it got listed in November 2007. It went down to the price of 25 rupees, right? And then from there, it started the journey of wealth creation. Okay, what led to the rise will not be just the fundamental, right? It has to be whole host of things which is combining the growth of this company. वो कहते हैं ना, यू नो शाहरुख खान सेड इन दैट मूवी कि अगर आपको सक्सेसफुल करवाना है तो पूरी कायनात आपके साथ लगेगी, तब आप सक्सेसफुल हो सकते हो। बड़ा पैसा उसी स्टॉक में बनता है जहाँ पूरी कायनात लगेगी। तो इट इज़ नॉट जस्ट अबाउट मैनेजमेंट, द एंटायर इकोसिस्टम इज देयर टू बैक यू दैट यस वी वॉन्ट यू टू ग्रो। सो सरा इनिशियली दिस इज अ सिंपल बिजनेस, went up after the IPO price got clicked. So let us have a line chart only, simple line chart. So the moment it crossed its IPO price here, which was around 100 rupees, the stock started going up, okay? In this journey of stock going up, obviously the financial performance of the company would have been a great support for this company, okay? Let us try to retrieve the financial performance. The financials, let's see, we have revenue. Let us see the annual revenue and plot it here. All right. So Cera was generating an annual revenue of around 1.28 billion rupees here. And the revenue was growing. Annual revenue was steadily growing. Okay. Let's see. The annual revenue was growing and, you know, suddenly you see the steepness of the growth in revenue was much more aggressive than what it was earlier. You see 20%, 24%, 20%, 27%, 30%, 44%, 44%. This growth in revenue will always lead to higher than expected growth in the stock price. This is momentum. I hope you are getting it. Let me see if we have PE ratio here for 2008. I'm not sure. I will have to see whether there is data available. Oh, there is data available. So look at the PE ratio. It was around these levels, which was around 5, 6. As revenue growth became aggressive, the PE ratio, which was around 11, 12, went up to as high as 50 because of the aggressive revenue growth associated with that company. All right, the growth, this was an aggressive revenue growth. Maybe the business cycle supported this kind of a revenue growth. Then the revenue growth became kind of flattened, 23, 11, 10, 17. So this was not as aggressive growth as probably it was. So the stock remained round about here. Yes, it went up because the market was going up, although the stock revenue was not growing as much as it was growing earlier. This is bubble. This is where the market forces, because the market is tejy, everyone is bullish, the stock is also bullish. Because of this, the PE ratio of the company went up to as high as 70. Remember, if a company becomes expensive and the revenue growth is not supporting the justification of it being expensive, the market price will crash. So Cera crashed from this level, 4000 level, to almost 2000 level because revenue was not growing. In fact, there was degrowth of revenue in this phase. Then again, the journey got initiated when some bit of, you know, as we call it, moonshots, some bit of moonshots got visible. Maybe management change happened, maybe management gave a different impression about the company. So the moonshots got visible in 2021, and the stock price again started going up with an expectation that the management is going to walk the talk. That means they're going to perform what they are expected to do. And the stock price again went up because the revenue growth was quite handsome, right? Now let us call revenue again. So let us go to finance, and this time we'll see the quarterly revenues, okay? So let's see. So this is quarterly revenue data, okay? Quarterly revenue data we don't have for historical, but yearly we have historical, and quarterly we have only till a limited time frame, 5 or 6 years in trading view. So you see the quarterly revenue peaked here, and the stock price was again going up because of the expectation, because it was believed that real estate story has started in India and the stock price will ride on back of that real estate story. But the revenue got flattened in last 2-3 quarters. So the stock, which went to as high as 9,000 here, almost 10,000, it crashed and now it is trading at around 7,000. Okay. So valuation leads to long-term sustainable price action. There will be pockets in the middle which will boost valuation. Why? Because of the support of the business cycle, in that pocket, the company will show extraordinary performance and the stock will become very, very expensive. Right? So what do we do now? Yeah. If you look at the stock in its current form, the financials are currently almost flat. The stock price is also trading at a long-term price earning multiple average, which is around this. Revenue growth annual is stable, 17-24. If management comes and give a clarity or a guidance that, you know, this company is going into XYZ, and if the capex cycle from the company is also, in fact, let us see if we have fixed asset here, because fixed asset becomes a very important part of the thought process of the management. So let's see, gross block is there, gross block, gross property, plant and equipment. Okay, let's see on an annual basis, do we have increase in the gross block? Yes. So look at this, the company in the last 5-6 years have invested, and the gross block has increased. No, actually last 5 years, the gross block has not increased. It has been flat. So if the company is not doing capex, how will the company go to the next level? So basically, currently, as far as current state is concerned, there is no reason for one to buy Cera, because there is no expected earning surprise which we can get from this company. All right, now let's go to another company called Asian Paints. The same story, let's try to see from the initial days. So Asian Paints started in 1999, and the stock, let's try to zoom in. Okay, it went up initially, went down, and then when it crossed this, that period high, which was around these levels, around 43, if you look at the annual performance, the sales growth was 26%, 24%, 15, 9, 11. So the year when the sales growth was very high, the stock used to outperform. The years when the sales growth was timid and it was not growing as much as it was doing historically, the stock would not perform significantly. The beauty about Asian Paints as a consistent compounder is that these are the stocks which have been consistently growing on a year-on-year basis, right? What is happening with Asian Paints right now? Well, if you look at the stock price, it has kind of, it is staying in a long-term range now. Range between 3,500 and 2,600. This is the range, broader range of the stock. If I look at the quarterly revenue growth, it is also kind of flat for last two, three quarters. As far as PE is concerned, it is now coming back to lower end of the price and multiples, historical range. And as far as gross block is concerned, the company has been making regular investments and the gross block has been increasing consistently. So if I am an Asian Paint lover, then I will definitely start looking at this stock because it is now trading at the lower end of the long-term range which has been defined for this stock. Okay, so this is broadly, I'm giving you an understanding of the life journey of a stock, but definitely we will try to understand how to participate in these stocks in a much better manner in this section of our discussion. This is a very specific example which I am giving to you. I mean, I have explained this entire journey of momentum investing in this webinar which I took, where I've discussed a lot of strategies also. So if you like to learn more from me, take this webinar. The link is below this video. It's going to add a lot of value. Or the best thing is become part of StockEdge Club. You will enjoy so much. This entire journey of learning will be so mindful, full of mindfulness and full of fun, that you will start feeling stock market to be part of your lovely, lovely ecosystem. So take this webinar. The link is below the video. I hope you will enjoy the interactions.